Our previous lecture, we were looking at ICMP messages and we saw that it could either do error reporting or querying of message. So last lecture, we studied about destination unreachable and source quench. In this lecture, we will learn about error reporting for time exceeded, parameter problems and redirection of messages. So we will look at them one by one. So this time we will look at time limit exceeding. Okay, so what happens in this case? So we have, so to understand this time exceeded, we should note about time to live field in a IP header. So because of many things, routed can become infinite. Okay, so for example, if there is a loop in your routing table, then what will happen? Let's say this was the source, this was the destination, but somehow there was a routing loop created. So in this case, what will happen if a packet falls in the loop? It will keep on moving in this loop forever and the bandwidth will be wasted. So how to remove these infinite length path? So there is a concept of TTL. Okay, what it says is that we will start with a maximum value of TTL, and each router, whenever a packet is traversing, each router will decrement its value. So let's say that I make that, okay, any path should not be longer than 8. So I will set the TTL initially to 8. The packet starts here, and let's say it was going inside a loop. So it will become 7 here, then it will go to this router, it will become 6. It goes here, it will be decremented, it becomes 5. It goes here, it will become 4. Then here, it will become 3. Then to this place, it will become 2. Then to this one, it will become 1. And finally, again in this loop, it will become 0. Okay. So TTL now becomes 0. And I know that, okay, maximum hop limit has been reached by my packet. So it will send. Now some error reporting mechanisms should be there that, okay, it did not reach D and it is somehow it exceeded the hop length. So ICMP error message will come to the source. So whenever a router decrements a datagram with a time to live value becomes 0, it discards the datagram so that it does not keep on moving inside the loop or somehow wrong routing, and it sends a time exceeded message to the original source that, okay, time has exceeded, it has not reached its destination. So this is one way or time exceeded can happen. So the type will be time exceeded, but there is another way in which it can happen, and that is problem of fragmentation. So I will tell you a little bit about fragmentation also. Each of the MAC layer, okay, so have different maximum data units. So some can have a frame of 1500 bytes. Some can only handle frames of 300 bytes, let's say. So when a packet is coming from this data link layer to this one, the frame has to be divided into smaller pieces that are called fragments. So this 1500 bytes, if here its maximum is only 300 byte, it needs to be divided into frame 1, frame 2, frame 3, frame 4 and frame 5, and all of them will be. Now when the destination, it comes to the destination, it will again arrange all of these. So now what happens, let's say the frames were coming to this destination and it could not, there was some time limit that, okay, in let's say 2 seconds I should get all the fragments of a packet. But if it did not get, let's say F1, F3, F5 and F4 it got, but F2 it did not receive in the set time limit, then it can say that, okay, time exceeded, I could not receive all the fragments to reassemble. So this is another problem. Okay, so time exceeded ICMP error message will be the same, but subcategory will be different. The code will be that, okay, it is an error time exceeded, but from the code you can find that, okay, is it due to fragmentation or is it due to TTL value becoming 0. So this has type 11 and code is either 0 or 1. 0 will be for TTL value becoming 0 and 1 for like your fragmentation. So code is 0 is used only by routers to show that value of time to live has become 0. Code 1 will show about the fragments, as I told you. Then we have the parameter problem. Parameter problem message can be created by a router or the destination host. Okay, so what it tells that okay, some kind of parameters are not set properly. So type is 12 and code is 0 or 1. Okay, then we have redirection concept. So what is redirection? So I'm on LAN, A is the machine, it sends one IP packet to B. But it sends it to router R1. Okay, there are two gateway routers. It sends it to R1. R1 now says that okay, it knows that B is on the this side, and it tells that okay, redirection message it gives to A so that it can update that okay, if it wants to reach B, it has to go via R2. But it will send the IP packet to R2 and it will send a error message saying that please update your table regarding the destination address B, your gateway router is R2, and this will be generated usually at the in the net, same network as the host. So this is good for filling out the routing table. A host usually starts with a small routing table and gradually it is augmented and updated by these redirection message. And its type is 5 and code can be 0 to 3. Okay, so it means their redirection message has many different, it can be generated by many different ways. Okay, so if you are sending it to router, a redirection message is sent from a router to a host on the same network. Okay, because initially only you will be sending wrong. Now we will look at the query message. Okay, so this will be in our next lecture. We will learn about the ICMP query messages that are used for debugging and error handling purpose. So I hope you understand this. Thanks a lot.